This is Tom Dillon, the lifetime liberal, and today is Friday, March 6, 2020. The title of this rant is from Billy Joel, "Honesty is hardly ever heard, but mostly what I need from you." So as the coronavirus continues to expand, and it will expand greatly when tests are available in the United States, if they're available in the United States, the stock market is tanking again. And we have the World Health Organization, we have the Pentagon, we have basically all the governors of all the states, mayors, city council people, etc., businesses, school districts, etc., giving out long, detailed, very fact-based information regarding the coronavirus and what can be done about it and what they anticipate doing if it ever reaches them or as they're trying to contain it right now. And what are we hearing from the White House? Absolutely nothing. Peeps, basically, things are going well. We're doing an incredible job. We've done a better job than anyone else ever could have done. We're getting high marks for it. And oh, by the way, we inherited this from Obama. All of this is not factual information, and we know this. We need leadership at the top. Just one of the things that came out just this morning is the markets are tanking again. And of course, the markets are reacting to uncertainty. They're also reacting to the fact that this guy has absolutely no idea what he's doing. He has fourth and fifth string players on his team, so to speak. They all suck. They would never be in any other administration. They're grifters. They're looking for an easy buck, and they're willing to do anything that this guy says so that they can maintain some levers of power for themselves. It just came out this week that there was an anticipation that they would have up to 1 million test kits available, I think, by the end of this week. Only 75,000 are available. What is that? That's a 90% less than what was anticipated or that what was told. You know, other countries are, basically smacking us all over the place with how quickly, how reliably, and, let's just say, well-managed response. I mean, there's no good well-managed. Some people are going to get hurt all along. And of course, businesses are showing this uncertainty, especially airlines, especially travel agencies, especially hotels, as things are being cut back. Our distribution lines are in Iraq because we can't get stuff out of China fast enough. And all of this is crying out for presidential leadership, which we don't have. And I think the things that really need to be stressed right now in, let's just say, a calm and uncertain way by our friends on the Democratic side is that this is what the result of what you get when you hire a con man to do the greatest, the most important job in the entire world. And it also is a clear indication, especially with some of his, speeches, his town hall meetings, his talk to the press in the last 2 weeks, is that the media still will not address his unfitness for office. And this needs to be hammered day in and day out, that this guy is unfit for office. And this is why we should never have elected him in the first place and why we need to get rid of him. And there are a lot of things that were going in his favor for this reelection. Maybe this will stop it, maybe it won't. But again, this guy, as a manager, has absolutely no idea what to do. His people are have no idea what to do. The entire world, governors, senators, congresspeople, mayors, city council people, school districts, businesses, they're all trying desperately hard to do it. There's nothing this guy is doing that's showing us. And again, it shows the media needs to emphasize every single day from now on that this guy is unfit for office.